exciting is I've lived about a block away from Make-It Springfield for the last couple years, and so I've actually seen the physical transformation of adding art, music, change, bringing new kinds of people into this downtown area. We've actually seen it grow and develop a new impact and make a difference in people's lives.
I loved how it's morphed, because when we first came in the first day, it was just those white walls, there was just nothing, and it has completely changed. Like, I mean, you just see all this, and the young people, when we bring them in, they come, same as me, I mean, they come in and we're just like, what? And then you see everything, so it's exciting, and the community has created this space.
A lot of people who come here are willing to really donate materials and get it, like, up and running, and I thought that was really cool, because I personally didn't think there was anything lively going on downtown except for like working and all that stuff. So when this space came here, it was really cool for people to bring like their little siblings to get out of the house. And it's a great way for people to communicate and like interact.
So much love. You get what I'm saying? They show so much love and respect. It's awesome. It's just a great space that you feel comfortable. The makers welcome you in. Other partakers, they welcome you in. And it's just like, this is awesome.
My name is Tyreek and I'm 14.
I'm 11, my name is Jaden.
Do you think like there should be more places like this in like Springfield?
Yes.
Yeah. Why?
Because like at first like with like say if you wanted to get a part from Walmart, you would have to pay for that. But you come here, you could get a part and you could add it onto your bike. And if you don't know how to do it, there's people here that could like teach you how to fix bikes.
And some stuff is you can do like donations.
Yeah, donations.
I pitch it as a free way to gain skills and knowledge. That's what we want to enable for the Springfield population, is cheap or free access to skills, information, and teaching and learning that isn't necessarily something that you'd see in schools, because there's plenty that you can teach and learn that's outside of the school program, and we're here to help. You know, you can play many roles in shops like this. That, you know, you can, there's always skills to be learned from everybody, and that's, you know, we're just one part of that great web around here.
I'm Ariel and I'm 14. If you're into drawing, if you're into coloring or painting, I would definitely recommend this place, because you can just do whatever you want to do.
I think the biggest issue that we have out here is that we don't have a place for kids to go to learn something or to do something productive with themselves. Never mind just kids, but just people in general. We don't have a place where we can go to do something constructive. To have this place is not just a blessing, but it's an honor, you know what I mean? Because it gives these kids a place to come where they can take their bikes, fix them, and now they're learning something. And all the places that we have out here, it costs money to go there. You know, and all the places that we have out here, there's a specific agenda that is not detailed to the customer or not detailed to the people. This place is. You know, if you want to be a part of change and you want to be a part of creating change, not just for yourself, but for other people and for the generations to come, what better place to go? What better place to do these things? Art galleries, poetry jams, places where you can go, where you can just walk in and see people doing things like that. It's rare. It's rare. And we need a whole lot more of that.